Today on Jimbo Vision, La La Land. Hello there. On a list of things I thought the world didn't need, an old-fashioned, unironic, live-action Hollywood musical was right up there with an extra month of 2016. Well, how wrong I was. For here comes Damien Chazelle's all-singing and dancing new picture, and it's an absolute stunner. Uplifting like a Beverly Hills surgeon, are pretty much guaranteed to warm your heart, even in these dark times we're living in. Chazelle, you recall, has previously wowed us all with Whiplash, the distinctly unsentimental tale of one boy's struggle to get jazz hands. La La Land is actually an earlier script of his, which he'd previously struggled to get off the ground, because, you know, it's a musical. And boy, is it a bold one, opening with a full-blown chorus line number that sees motorists high-stepping out of their vehicles up on an LA freeway ramp, a traditional spot, of course, for a jam. From here, it's clear that Chazelle's motto is, do make a song and dance about things, as he tells us the story of two young Angelinos, Mia and Sebastian, and the romance that awaits them. Mia, Emma Stone, is an aspiring actress.
I can do it a different way.
Oh, that's fine. Thank you very much.
Sebastian, a never smoother Ryan Gosling, wants to open a jazz bar. As their stories become entwined, it's pretty clear to us that they soon will be too. And even while the pair continue to tell themselves and each other there's really no chance, their feet are spelling out a different story. Now, Chazelle has some powerful ingredients to work with here. Those incredible LA sunsets, which, thanks to the pollution, really are unbeatable for everything except, well, breathing. The chemistry of his leads, Stone and Gosling here, in their third film together, never hitting a bum note, even when they do. And then there's the music by Justin Hurwitz. Now, Hurwitz is actually an old college friend of Chazelle's from Harvard who's collaborated on all three of his pictures so far, sort of a he shoots, he scores arrangement. His work for La La Land is utterly charming, just as well as you'll be humming bits of it for months after, catchy as chickenpox in a kindergarten. And what a contrast, by the way, with Chazelle's last film, Whiplash. While music there very much a dark and jealously destructive force in the story, here it's the balm that soothes an often bittersweet tale.
City of stars, are you shining just for me? City of stars, there's so much that I can't see. Who knows, is this the start of something wonderful and new? Or one more dream that I cannot make true.
It's another Twilight saga, this. Well, with a supporting cast that includes J.K. Simmons as A Man Who Hates Jazz, Rosemary DeWitt and John Legend, and with a soundtrack that even sneaks in a little bit of Flock of Seagulls, La La Land is an absolute treat to look at and to listen to. Also, okay, anyone can point a camera at Magic Hour and have it look pretty special, but the cinematography by Linus Sandgren, who did American Hustle, also deserves a pretty big hand. Given indeed Chazelle's penchant for filming in long and unforgiving takes, a huge amount of hard work has gone into making La La Land seem so effortless. The result, though, is a movie that deserves its place among the classics. What I'm saying is, even if you don't like musicals, do yourselves a favour and see this one. Soaked in colour and joie de vivre, it is the best movie to combine love with big numbers since Good Will Hunting. La La Land gets a whopping 9 out of 10 on Jimbo Vision. I'm off to have a lie down. You let me know what you think underneath.